Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. And in this video, we're going to talk about Preferences Data Store in Android. So what is Preferences Data Store? So Preferences Data Store is actually used to store small piece of information like key value pair. So previously we were doing the same thing with the help of shared preferences, but shared preferences has a lot of flaws. So shared preferences execute their task in main thread. So sometime it will crash your application, and also you are not able to perform asynchronous operation with shared preferences. But here with the help of preferences data store, you can perform asynchronous operation. Also under the hood, all of the tasks that you will perform with preferences data store on dispatcher IO. So it will never crash your application. So enough talking, let's get started with our project and see how we can use this thing in our Android project. So first thing first, we need dependencies. Go to your build.gradle kts file and add this dependency. By the way, you will get this dependency from my GitHub repository link in the description box. So let's begin with our project. So here first we have to create a class, and the class name is pref utils. Now in this class I'm gonna pass context because we have to use this context. So first I'm going to create an instance of our data store. So private variable, by the way, this is an extension over context. So data store, initialize this thing with the help of preferences data store. In this we have to pass the name, just like we did pass name when we want to create shared preferences instance. So in place of name, I'm simply using here local. Okay. So now I'm going to create here two functions which actually used to save information and retrieve those save information. So I'm going to call this save string. First we have to pass our key. Next we have to pass our value. Okay, so use data store. By the way, data store is an extension over context. So use context.data store. Now in this we have edit. Now in this edit we are receiving mutable preferences, and in this mutable preferences, in place of index operator, we have to pass our key. But you can't pass directly key here because the required parameter that we want is preferences.key. So let's create that with the help of string preferences key. Now here you can pass your key. What it will do, it will simply generate the required thing. Corresponding to that, I'm going to store my value. That's it. It will simply store those information in the data store. Now it's time to fetch those information. So for that, we have a function naming getString. We have to pass string, and the return type of this function is string, and sometime it may null. Now return use data store dot data, use here map transformation function. Now in this I'm using the same thing. It in the index operator we are going to use string preferences key, pass my key. So what it will return, and it will return flow. So you can see over here return type is flow, and the flow type is string, which is nullable. So I want to simply take the first emission from that. Okay, so now this function is actually used to retrieve those information that you have been saved. So let's use all these things in our composable. So go to your main activity, remove everything. I'm going to create a composable, and the composable name is main screen, and the requirement of this main screen is our pref utils. So simply pass it in here. Okay, so now I'm going to use your column. In place of modifier, I'm using here fill max size. Its vertical arrangement is on the center, and its horizontal alignment is also on the center. Okay, so now in this we have two text field, two button, and one text composable. So let's create that. First we have text field. So we have first text field. Next we have spacer 12 dp. Import this dp. So just below to it, again, we have text field. Now first text field actually used for the key. Next text field is actually used for the value. Again, I'm going to use your spacer. Modifier has height of 12 dp. Okay. Lastly, we have buttons. So first button is actually used to save those information. Import this composable. Make sure this is coming from composable. In place of text, I'm using your save. Again, I am having a space, modifier, height is 12 dp. Just below to it, I am having a text. Now this text is actually used to show us the stored information. And when do we fetch those stored information? So by pressing on this button, we will fetch those information. So I'm going to call this fetch info. Okay, so now it's time to create few states. So on the top, I'm having a state naming key. Initialize the thing with the help of remember mutable state of empty string. Similarly, we have one more naming value. remember mutable state of empty string. And lastly, we have stored info. Initialize this thing with remember mutable state of empty string. Now just use everything. So here I'm using my key value, and if anything got changed, it will simply update my key value. And also in place of a modifier, I'm using fill max width. Alright, similarly for the next text field, I'm using here value dot value. If anything got updated, it will simply update my state. Okay. Lastly, just add modifier fill max width. For the button, when user click on it, I'm simply want to store the information. So for that, because our preference utils function are suspendable functions, so we have to execute those suspendable function within a coroutine. So let's create here a coroutine scope. With the help of remember coroutine scope, just create a scope. Now it's time to use it. Scope, launch a new coroutine, and now we are able to use our prefutil.save string. In this, use your key value, value.value. Next, when user click on this button, we have to fetch the saved information. So again, use your scope.launch, use your prefutils.getString, pass your key value, and store this information in our stored info state. Okay. All right. So we have a problem, and the problem is requirement is a string, but found is nullable string. So simply use here two string. Okay. In this text, I'm using my stored information value in place of style. I'm using material theme typography headline large. All right. So I hope everything is done. And also I want padding. So horizontally, I want 16 dp padding. And yeah, we are pretty much done. Now it's time to use our main screen in place of greetings. So just paste in here. In place of modifier, use a modifier, attach the padding, and use your inner padding which comes from our scaffold. Next, we have to pass our pref utils. So let's create pref utils instance on the top of our activity. So private while pref utils, initialize this thing with lazy block, use your pref utils, and simply pass context. Now simply use that prefutils over here. And yeah, we are pretty much done with our project. So now I'm going to execute this application in my Pixel 6a API level 33, not 28. Okay, so for the key, I'm using here key 1. For the value, I'm using here value 1. Now I'm simply save it. Okay, now when I click this fetch info, you can see value 1. Now use here key 2. And in place of value, use just value 2222. Save it. Now fetch it. You can see value 22. So by using this approach, you can use preferences data store in your Android project. And it has a lot of merit compared to shared preferences. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoy this video. It's a very short video, but at the same time, it is more informative video for those who want to perform asynchronous operation in their preferences, or you can say share preferences. So yeah, we'll meet our next video where we will discuss something new about Android. Till that, goodbye.